Gia, if you'd like to share the information about the Palisades program, since it was asked, and when basically it's a program that entices our scientists who are abroad, well, Filipinos or those of Filipino descent. So they may not be, well, maybe they may be naturalized or for their parents or grandparents of another nationality. So we provide incentives such as, well, their short-term and long-term engagements. And for short-term, we have allowances given them. And based on the terms of reference given them, they may have other incentives or allowances. And engagements with universities and some other government agencies. So for long term, we have as incentives payment of salaries, and there is hosting by academe who provides them the salary and housing. But in the new bill, we have included based on inputs from academe, the private sector, and industry, we have included additional incentives such as exemption from the Professional Regulation Commission, where they now they are required to seek permit from the PRC before they are allowed to practice their profession right in the country. That's for the long term. So that's in the bill. And another new item is allowing the members of the family, including the scientist, a temporary recognition of the citizenship. And so they are allowed to work. The family members are allowed to work. Giving additional allowance in transporting their personal effects grant for research. I'm not sure of the amount, but also in millions. And engaging, allowing them to engage more with industry. Also, the allowances that they shall receive shall be tax exempt. And there is an additional feature that there may be a medium-term engagement of scientists. Many of those who we invited would be unable to engage in a period longer than 3 months, so we have to have the engagements by monthly or per monthly basis. And they also will be, well, we're beefing up the capability of universities so that those who come from abroad would have better facilities to work in. And that is expanding and giving them an environment which would, although it may not be the ideal setting because we cannot immediately replicate what they have abroad, at least they can have a better facility, because they're going to use this to also share the experience with our locals. In that regard also, talking about innovations, which may not be focus on the organizational development aspect. So we have a new program. Secretary De La Peña has taken up the president's directive that we have to bring the programs closer to the people, and therefore now we're getting outside Metro Manila, beefing up the capability of universities in the regions, identifying their niche, and so it's a selective process. We provide assistance, technical and funding assistance to those universities where we see could contribute more in providing assistance to industry. Industry would come to the university and ask for assistance in the conduct of the research to help them with a new product or improved system. And then the university goes to DOST and asks for funding. We're giving the universities assistance through a research manager, a strong leader who can bring their research capability to a higher level. And so they not only upgrade their capability in the academics, but also in technology commercialization, helping industry. And of course, all these address the requirements of the harmonized national R&D agenda. This is an input of priorities identified by the different departments conducting research. Research remains to be conducted mainly by universities, public or private for that matter. And we fund those only which are identified in the harmonized national R&D agenda, both for basic research and applied research. And thank you for that opportunity of sharing the program of UST and with the governance program on right sizing. The UST is now conducting its own study on the functional and program review of the 18 attached agencies. Less one na yung DICT. ICT o dati. So move to any department. And with 16 regional offices. We ourselves feel the bigness of the department and the smallness of our budget. But we are fortunate that both houses of Congress are helping us, supporting us with bigger budgets. So we're able to focus on our priority areas. May I just also state that while we're doing the best we can to push further innovation. By the way, we are glad to hear the President mention during the ASEAN Leaders Conference that he pushes for innovation. Maybe what we'd like to see is the culture of innovation. Really, saan ba talaga? Kasi we also have different programs that help different sectors, academic industry, particularly UCEC Brenda handles the Small Enterprise Technology Upgrading Program, where we input S&T interventions, helps micro-small enterprises enhance their productivity. But really, we have encountered difficulties because many of our people, well, businesses also do not really have that picture of Filipino.